Finally, we're doing Bleak Falls Barrel.
Those thieves must be mad hiding out there. Those old crypts are filled with nothing but traps, trolls, and who knows what else.
Or maybe even as good as you?
Oh, I got the old default font installed. That's weird. I probably had something on my screen I couldn't read, so I had to go back to the original font.
Sure thing.
So I can read what the heck that message was that kept showing up on my screen. Because the magic card font that I'm using, it, sometimes stuff is too small to even see.
I mean, we have plenty of things in the shop that are worth just as much coin.
Yeah, the letters are only like 3 pixels high, so unreadable.
He never quite explained where he got it. He's a tricky one. This is the bridge out of town. The path up the mountain to the northwest leads to Bleak Falls Barrow. I guess I should get back to my brother. He'll throw a fit if I take too long. Such a child. Mara bless you for agreeing to help us.
I guess she doesn't like me staring at her. If she's modest, maybe she shouldn't be wearing that kind of outfit. Each day that I start dubbing over one of these videos, I keep thinking to myself that I need to do some Traveler videos. Traveler role-playing game. I just don't want to ramble in my Traveler video. I want to keep them nice and short, like maybe, you know, no more than 8 minutes long. And that means I need to script, I need to write down what I'm going to say in the video. And if I have to write down what I'm going to say in a video, then it's going to take a while, because I'm not a writer. Nor do I play one on TV. Where are my followers? Oh, I guess I'm gonna go by myself to this place.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver.
Your who died?
Let's see here. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Or maybe I mistreated somebody and I got a letter from someone saying, "Great job." So someone in Falkreath wants me to beat up somebody. I don't know where those quests come from.
What happened back there? The dragon, it... I've always known you were special. Maybe that's what it's been all along.
So dragons are now in my game. They're a thing now.
No matter what, it doesn't change who you are on the inside. That's what counts. So whatever comes next, count me in. I'll be right behind you. Anytime. Now come on, adventure awaits, remember?
So the plan was to have Arissa with me, because she's written for the main quest.
We're causing no trouble. All we ask is to look for her.
I don't care what you're doing. After what happened, you're lucky I don't toss you in jail. Now get lost.
We will be back. This is not over.
In the past, I've used Velia for the main quest. But I thought, I'll give Orisa a try. See what she says as the quest is progressing. So guess what happens if the Stormcloaks win the Civil War? That's right. Heimskur preaches for the entire playthrough of your game.
What else could it mean?
Actually, he'll preach forever, no matter what. He'll either be in prison doing it, or he'll be over by the Talos Shrine doing it.
The Greybeards.
We were just talking about you. My brother needs a word with you.
So what happened at the Watchtower? Was the dragon there? I knew I could count on Irileth, but there must be more to it than that. Dragonborn? What do you know about the Dragonborn? Not just the men. The Greybeards seem to think the same thing.
Didn't you hear the thundering sound as you returned?
Now, if I walk out of here right now, that's it. No house option. No Lydia.
Centuries, at least. Not since Tibur Septim himself.
But if I'm patient and I stand around.
Rungar, calm yourself. What does any of this Nord nonsense have to do with our friend here?
I'll get more trophies out of this little meeting we're doing here.
Him being this, what, Dragonborn?
Nord nonsense? Why, you puffed up ignorant. These are our sacred traditions that go back to the founding of the First Empire.
Hrongar, don't be so hard on Avanich.
I meant no disrespect, of course.
I'm just hoping I don't turn into a full-on vampire while these talking heads do their talking heads.
Not ours.
I don't want to have to kill everyone in this room.
You killed that dragon.
Just because I'm hungry a little bit.
Something in you. And the Greybeards heard it.
They don't notice I'm a vampire,
which
is good.
You're Dragonborn. Who are we to argue? You'd better get up to High Hrothgar immediately. There is no refusing the summons of the Greybeards. It's a tremendous honor. I envy you, you know, to climb the 7,000 steps again. I made the pilgrimage once. Did you know that? High Hrothgar is a very peaceful place.
Who's that?
Very disconnected from the troubles.
It's one of the crazy servants
in the house. I wonder that the Greybeards even notice what's going on down there. They haven't seemed to care before. No matter.
No matter.
Go to High Hrothgar. Learn what the Greybeards can teach you. You've done a great service for me and my city, Dragonborn. By my right as Jarl. I name you Thane of Whiterun. It's the greatest honor that's within my power to grant. I assign you Lydia as a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble, now would we? We are honored to have you as Thane of our city, Dragonborn. Back to business, Proventus. We still have a city to defend.
Yes, my lord.
Meanwhile, we got Lydia here. She's going to try to force greet me. Oh, she actually walks back to the door if I don't come near her. So she's going to stand there until I actually say, hello. Okay, now I can see her better.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your housecarl. It's an honor to serve you.
She's a bit plain Jane looking.
Take care of yourself.
Don't worry, she gets fixed up later. We got makeup We got wigs. We got outfits. We have mods.
I won't leave Whiterun defenseless, even for a day.
If we send half our guards to aid the legions, just for a few days, this is in the Empire's favor. The companions can help
sure thing.
The city, and the Emperor will be in our debt.
What do you need? I'm going to hit the tavern, maybe sell some things. I'll meet you outside the gates later.
The minute I buy a house, Lydia moves right into the house.
Up for a little hunting? Lead the way.
For now, she lives here until I buy the house. Whoop. Script jam. What's going on there? Give her some better hair.
What's on your mind? Is there anything else you need? I've got your back. Of course.
So I need her to get rid of her steel armor. That way I can give her other armors to wear.
Of course. I understand. Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision. Thank you. I'll be sure to put it to good use.
So now, whatever I give her to wear, she'll put it on.
Still here. Very good, sir.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar. I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
I found him dead in my last playthrough. Not sure how that happened. Maybe a grizzly got him or something. Anyway, so I'm, level 44 or something like that, and I'm heading up to High Hrothgar. It's my first time here in this playthrough.
From up here, everyone in Skyrim looks like ants, marching up and down roads and fighting over crumbs. It helps put your problems into perspective.
Oh, who died?
Let's see here. I've got a letter and a lot of gold. Something about it being your, inheritance. Oh, and sorry for your loss. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Oh, I think it's the beggar. The guy had a spear thrown through his chest or something. Yeah, nope. Oh, no, it's the guy who writes books. I had to eat. I was a vampire and I was hungry and I had to eat him. So I did. Man, we're just whipping through this.
I found the crown over here on this corpse. Is this the one we're looking for?
There
don't mind, King, we'll just be taking that crown of yours and be on our way.
Sure about this. The jagged crown
get to Windhelm with the crown as
was on his helmet he was wearing. So I think I broke him again. Because in my last playthrough, I think the jagged crown was on his head. And he wasn't wearing a helmet. Because that doesn't make sense to be wearing a helmet and then you wear the jagged crown on the helmet. Just came here for the word wall, to be honest, so I can get all the dragon shouts that I can.
Looks like that's it. Got to go.
What? Who died now? I didn't do anything yet. I had a feeling I knew who it was, and then sure enough, it was that person. The farmer over at Whiterun. What's his name? Severio, that guy. He's dead. The attack on Whiterun hasn't even started yet, and he's already dead there. So maybe he died from, like, heart attack or something? Natural causes? He died before his house got bombed, basically. It's a setup. He was murdered, and then somebody put him in his house where his house would get nuked to make it look like, oh, he died during the war.
You think this is personal? The Empire has no place in Skyrim.
Oh.
Not anymore.
Orisa's down for the count. I had to stop using Orisa because she was always getting knocked down.
You have
always.
No place in Whiterun anymore.
A convenient position to hold now.
She's a bleeder.
But mark my words.
She's one of those hemophiliacs.
In the days to come, Ulfric will spread his rebellion thin. And what then? We need the Empire as much as it needs us. We Nords are the Empire. Our blood built it. Our blood sustains it. You, of all people, should know that.
If this was my Empire, I'd be able to worship whoever I damned well pleased. You wish to see an Empire without Talos? Without its soul? We should be fighting those witch elves, not bending knee to them. The Emperor is nothing more than a puppet of the Thalmor. Skyrim needs a High King who will fight for her. And Whiterun needs a Jarl who will do the same.
Tell me, Vignar, was all this worth it? How many of those corpses lining our streets wear the faces of
Keep
men
your
who
distance.
Once called you friend? What about their families?
I've got my eyes on you.
Enough! Both of you! There is a burning city out there that needs a government.
He's right. Galmar, come.
Let so I gotta hug her goodbye. She's gonna get exiled to solitude soon.
This isn't over. Hear me, you old fool. This isn't over. And you, a storm cloak. I'd thought better of you. You'll all come to regret this day.
Get over to Windhelm. Tell Ulfric of our victory here.
What's with the Lara Croft haircut? Anyway, let's go make sure that they get escorted out of the building. Somewhere around this time is when one of my kids got broke.
Stories of this day.
Get over to Windhelm.
He's already sitting in the chair as Jarl. That's kind of cool. I don't remember that happening that quick. I thought you had to leave and come back and then he'd be Jarl.
Unblooded.
Yeah, when I come back here, he's got a Jarl outfit on, so that's how I remember him being a Jarl.
I surrender. Give me a few hours to gather my household, and I'll depart.
A few hours? It takes me 5 minutes to empty out your room.
I've got my eyes on you.
You got like some taffy candy, a sweet roll, a coin purse. You had some books, and I think there's like an iron dagger. That's it. As for your personal belongings. Let's just double check that they're actually doing something. Not just lollygagging. The Romanovs.
If you're planning violence against me or mine, you'll regret it.
Please, have mercy, I beg you. Please, have mercy, I beg you.
What? I don't remember the servants being sent away.
If you're planning violence against me or mine, you'll regret
it.
Please,
have mercy, I beg you.
Please, have mercy, I beg you.
Whatever. I'll have to check and see. I think the servants stayed in my Dragon's Reach. I don't think they went to Solitude. Jarls come and Jarls go.
I'm pretty sure I killed more than you. I was counting. Until next time.
He's been hanging out at someone's house. I don't remember whose though.